Hello everyone. Good morning to all. I am Ankita Bhagat, your science teacher from Sahajanand English Medium School at Nathdwara. So students, in our previous session, part 1, we were discussed about coal. And from the coal we get coke, coal tar and coal gas. But in this session, we will discuss about the next part, that is petroleum, right? You know that the petrol is used as a fuel in a light automobile such as motorcycle, scooters and cars, and which is also used in heavy motor vehicles such as trucks, tractors, which is run on diesel. So the petrol and diesel are obtained from the natural resource called petroleum. So petrol and diesel both are obtained from the natural resources, which is called petroleum. And the word petroleum, here the word petroleum, it derived from petra. So what is meaning of petra? So petra means rock and oleum means oil. And as it is mined from the between the rocks under the earth as shown in figure 5.4. Right? So we can say that the petroleum is a dark oily liquid from which we get the many valuable substances such as petrol, diesel, lubricating oil, paraffin wax, kerosene, etc. So from the petroleum we get the substances, again I repeat, we get the substances like petrol, diesel, lubricating oil, paraffin wax and diesel, right? And how the petrol is formed? Let us discuss about. So the petroleum was formed from the organism living in the sea. As their organism died, their bodies settled at the bottom of the sea. So the petroleum was formed from the organism which is lived in sea. As the organism died, their bodies settled at the bottom of the sea and got covered with the layer of sand and clay. So the sand and clay deposited over the body, and over the million years, absence of air, high temperature and the high pressure transformed the dead organism into the petroleum and natural gas. So after a few years, after the few not but the million years, the absence of air, high temperature and the high pressure, it transformed to the dead organism into the petroleum and natural gas. So these were petrol is formed, right? Now students, I will show you one video how to petrol is formed.
Formation of petroleum. Let us study the formation of petroleum. Petroleum was formed from organisms living in the sea. It was formed by a complex process. As these organisms died, their bodies settled. It was formed by a complex process. These organisms died, their bodies settled at the bottom of the sea and got covered with layers of sand and clay. Over millions of years, absence of air, high temperature and high pressure transformed the dead organism into petroleum and natural gas. Petroleum layer is formed above the underground water layer, as it is lighter than water. Petroleum is a non-renewable resource, and is used on a very large scale. The world's first oil well was drilled in Pennsylvania, USA, in 1859. About 8 years later, that is, in 1867, oil was found at Mukum in Assam. In India, oil is also found in Gujarat, Mumbai High, and in the basins off Godavari and Krishna.
So you see that how the petroleum is formed, right? So the first of all, the petroleum is drilled in USA in 1859, and after 8 years, we found in 1867 in Assam. Then after, also, which is found in Gujarat, Bombay, in the high in the river, that is Godavari and Krishna, right? So these were petroleum is formed. And here the figure number 5.4 given to you, that is petroleum and natural gas deposits, how it's deposits. So when they animals settle down on the bottom of the sea, we get the petroleum and natural gas. So here impervious rock. So impervious rock, it means not allowed fluid to pass through it, right? It is very hard. Below the impervious rock, here the impervious rock, below the impervious rock, the some natural gases are present, because gases is lighter than liquid. And above the water and below the gas, oil is present, because the density of oil is lower than water. That's why they float on water, right? Now refining of petroleum. So we know about the petroleum, but how to refine the petroleum, and from that we get the valuable substances such as petroleum gas, petrol, diesel, lubricating oil, paraffin wax, kerosene, etc. we get from the petroleum, right? So petroleum, you know very well, the petroleum is a dark oily liquid. It has unpleasant odor. Odor, it means it has unpleasant sound, a smell. It is a mixture of various constituents. It is a mixture of various substances such as petrol, diesel, lubricating oil, paraffin wax, etc. And the process of separating the various constituents, fraction of petroleum, is known as refining. And the process of separating the substances from the petroleum, it's called the petroleum refining, right? And it is carried out in the petroleum refinery. So the petroleum refinery in our Gujarat, which is situated in Jamnagar, you all are familiar with the Reliance industry, right? So in Jamnagar, the petroleum refinery is present. Got it? So here table number 5.1 given to you, in that the various constituents, the various substances of the petroleum and their uses also given. So when we boil, when we heat the crude oil, the various substances of petroleum we get, and their use is also different, right? Now let us discuss the table number 5.1. If in a petroleum the heat pass up to 20 degree Celsius, the petroleum gas we get. So the petroleum gas we get in the liquid form LPG. The full form of LPG is liquefied petroleum gas, which is used at our home to cook food. What is the use? The fuel for home and industry, right? Now the second substance we have, that is petrol. If the crude oil or petroleum we heat on the 200 degree Celsius, we get petrol. So approx 200 to 150 degree Celsius, we get petrol, which is used in motor, which is used in motor fuel, aviation fuels, solvent for a dry cleaning, right? Now the next we have, that is kerosene. So if the petroleum heat on a 200 to 150 degree Celsius, 200 degree Celsius, we get kerosene, which is used in fuel for the stove, lamps, and for the jet aircraft. Now the next substance we have, that is diesel, which is used in a heavy motors vehicles such as truck, buses, etc., and the electric generator, right? Now the next substance, that is lubricating oil. So if we heat the lubricating oil paraffin wax, if we heat the petroleum on 400 degree Celsius, we get the lubricating oil paraffin wax and the bitumen. And the lubricating oil, which is used in lubrication in machines, so that's why machine can run freely, right? And the paraffin wax, that is ointments, candle, and Vaseline. And we already learned about the bitumen. So bitumen is used in paints and metalling the rods. What it? So these are the substances we get from the petroleum. And if we are heat from the different temperature, we get the different substances from that, such as petroleum gas, LPG, petrol, kerosene, diesel, lubricating oil, paraffin wax, and bitumen. Now many useful substances obtained from petroleum and natural gas, and these are formed as a petrochemicals, and these are used in the manufacture of detergents, fibers. So which type of fibers? That is polyester, nylon, acrylic, etc. Again I repeat, the many useful substances are obtained from the petroleum and natural gas. So these are termed as a petrochemical, and these are used in the manufacture of detergent, fibers. So which type of fiber? That is polyester, nylon, acrylic, etc. And polythene and the other man-made plastics, hydrogen gas obtained from the natural gas, is used in the production of fertilizer, urea, right? And due to its great commercial importance, petroleum is also called the black gold, which is very useful in the commercial, that's why we can say that the petroleum is black gold, right? Which is a huge use in industries. Now the next and the last topic we have, that is natural gas. So third exhaustible natural resources, that is natural gas. So the natural gas is very important fossil fuel. It is very important fossil fuels because it is very easy to transport through the pipes. And natural gas is stored under the high compressor into the cylinder. So under the high pressure, it's stored in the cylinder, right? Natural gas is stored under the high pressure is compressed natural gas, that is CNG. The full form of CNG is compressed natural gas, which is full form. That CNG is used for the power generation and it is not being used given as a fuel for the transport vehicle because it is less polluting. It is also used fuel for the transport vehicle because it is less polluting as compared to petrol. And it is cleaner fuel. The great advantages of the CNG is that it can be used directly for the burning in homes and factories, and where it can be of piles exist in Vadodara. So the bigger plant of CNG, that is in Vadodara, and nowadays in Pune also the CNG plants are there, right? Some parts of Delhi and the other places. So in Gujarat, that is in Vadodara, and some parts of Delhi. Here the natural gas is also used as a starting material for the manufacturing of number of chemicals and fertilizers. It is also used in the number of chemicals and fertilizer, and India has a vast resources of the natural gas. And in our country, natural gas has been found in where? That is Tripura, Rajasthan, Maharashtra, in Krishna Godavari Delta. Got it? So these are the use and the places where CNG plants are found, right? Now the last topic, that is some natural resources are limited. So you have studied in the beginning of the chapter that some natural resources are exhaustible. It means it is limited in stock, like fossil fuels and forest minerals, etc. And you know that the coal and petroleum are fossil fuels. Coal and petroleum both are the exhaustible natural resources which is very limited in stock. It required the dead organism millions of years to get converted into these fuels, right? And moreover, the burning of these fuels is a major cause of air pollution. So most of the burning of fuels at that time, it released the carbon dioxide, and the carbon dioxide ultimately it causes the air pollution, and the air pollution ultimately causes the global warming. They directly linked to the global warming, right? And it is there. It is therefore necessary that we use their fuels only when absolutely necessary. So he has suggested that if it is necessary, then you have to use this fuel because it is limited in stock, and this will result in better environment. That's why this result will in better environment, because the pollution is less and it also less pollution is there. That's why it is better for the environment. Now, smaller risk of a global warming and their availability for a longer period of time. So if we use in the limited way, that's why as a result we get the better environment. Here, better environment, smaller risk in global warming, and their availability for the longer period of time. So in India, Petroleum Conservation Research Association, here the PCRA, the full form of PCRA is Petroleum Conservation Research Association, advises people how to save petrol, diesel while driving. So here given some tips. So the tips is that drive at a constant and moderate speed as far as possible. So that's drive at a constant speed and constant and moderate speed as far as possible. Switch off the engine at a traffic lights or at a place where you have to wait. and ensure correct tire pressure and ensure regular maintenance of the vehicle. So these way we conserve the petrol. These are the tips given. So students, our chapter is over here. I hope you all are understood very well. Now next video we will upload in next session. Thank you. Have a nice day.